just a camera, Harry. First a Canon M50.
Been wanting this for so long. I'm so happy I could cry. Dual pixel autofocus. Yes!
Okay, so I just got a camera that does video autofocus, which isn't the latest nor by no means the best, and I bought it secondhand actually, but it's new to me and all I need to finally do vlogs and record myself in focus with ease and efficiency. I'm super excited to put it through its paces and shoot around with it and try vlogging outside for the first time. Hey yo, how's it going, lovely people? My name is Brian. Welcome to my channel where I talk about eye-catching art and eye-catching things. Today I wanted to go around the city of Toronto. What up? Yeah, I just wanted to take you to a little tour around Toronto whilst showing you the murals that my mates and I have done in the past. So buckle up and enjoy the ride. The Canon M50 came out in 2018, but I've never used a camera with wireless connectivity before, and damn, I've been missing out. It connects to my phone and allows me to control the M50 wirelessly, which is cool and super useful, especially in a situation like this, where I can't be fiddling around with the camera buttons while driving. P.S. I only do this in slow speed zones for obvious safety reasons. Welcome to West Scarborough Neighborhood Community Center. Now, this is really where it started for me as a muralist back in 2011. So I was given the opportunity to work as a project coordinator for this art youth program, and West Scarborough Neighborhood Community Center has what's called a Youth Justice Services. It's a program for youth who have trouble with the law, and you know, they connect with community organizations such as West Scarborough Neighborhood Community Center, and through the arts are able to do community service hours for minor infractions. So my job as a project coordinator for the graffiti transformation project wasn't just about, you know, getting these younger folks who have run-ins with the law, who's got to do the community service hours, do these murals, but it's really kind of, you know, a huge deal in terms of serving as an alternate program that is restorative and not punitive, and really look into their roles as young members of the community. Aww. Mayor Rob Ford back in 2011 or 2012, I can't remember anymore, axed this program. And that was really problematic because for most of these kids that are that were part of these programs, it was also a job for them. And this is really important because, you know, it gives work experience to the younger folks that were a part of this program. Now, you know, these are younger folks who have to deal with criminal records, and a lot of them are people of color, and so they already face, you know, certain discriminations. So with all these other facets of the program, not just being a mural creation program, but, you know, really working with youth and looking at life skills and building their capacities, it was in many respects a form of crime prevention, and really look into alternative pathways to build themselves up as people, as community members, and just to build up for themselves a better future. Working in a community setting such as this was by far one of the most important and eye-opening learning experiences, and contrasted the highly individualistic training I had during my university years, because it repurposed my role and understanding of what being an artist means in a participatory and collective way. So I wasn't only an individual artist with a particular skill set and expertise, but I was also responsible in transferring these skills, listen and learn from my community members, and help develop participants artistically and creatively through the visual arts. We surveyed folks who regularly use the facility and asked them what they wanted to see as murals to involve them in the creation process and take ownership of the resulting pieces. back inside my car now. Man, it's getting really mucky and yucky out there with this wet snow. There are a couple more pieces that I wanted to show, but they're inside right now. Obviously with the lockdown, can't go in there, but luckily I have some snapshots of it that I've taken in the past. So the next site isn't too far from here. It's about a couple of blocks down. So let's get to it. Okay, so the gates are closed right now, so I can't park my car in there, but I'm just gonna have to go by foot. Now we're here at Prairie Drive Park on Pharmacy Avenue, and we're here to visit two sites right now. One is by the community garden, which is just right up there. And the other is just right across the street, actually. You can see it right... I hope you can see that, but anyways, we'll get a closer look for you to be able to see better. So we're safely parked at the side, so let's go check out the mural. This is a community garden, and this was such a nice place to work at during the summer when I was creating the murals here. And I have a couple here. And the first one is actually using my good friend Cherry as a model to be Mother Earth. Check it out. Oh wow, this is nice. She hasn't been tagged at all after all these years. There she is. I'm not entirely sure what they're used for, but I think they're utility boxes or like electric utility boxes used by the city. So I chose to portray Mother Earth here because this is a space where a lot of people grow a lot of things. It's a very multicultural community that they have here, and they grow all sorts of vegetables, fruits and vegetables from all over the world. And so I couldn't think of anything more befitting than to paint a personification of Mother Nature. Now, the folks who occupy this during growing season are from the Teesdale community, mainly from those high rises at the back. Hopefully you can see that right back there. But, oh man, I'm so happy that she hasn't been tagged all these years. Good to see you again, my old friend. Now, in the same community garden, I created another piece alongside Mother Nature. And it was a bit more about spirituality and just kind of looking at the relationship of the physical and how that feeds our spiritual and vice versa. Ah, and there it is. And it's tagged pretty badly. There it is. Pretty sad to see, but what are you gonna do? I mean, this happens all the time. It's like, it's supposed to be a block of cheese, and so you might recognize this as the face of the Buddha. And on the one side there, it is a loaf of bread, or a slice of bread rather, and a cheese. And that's kind of, you know, supposed to represent the physical. And then it transforms into the face of the Buddha. And a lotus, which signifies, of course, spirituality. It gets worse at the back. Let's check it out. There's a lot more graffiti there. Just check that out there. I mean, I'm a fan of graffiti, but... So, Prairie Drive Park, if you're ever in Toronto, at least the Mother Nature mural is still intact. It's still very nice to look at. Yeah, so this area, Prairie Drive Park, is by the Teesdale neighborhood, Teesdale community area, and it's just by Victoria Park Station. Just right across the street is another mural that I've done under the Graffiti Transformation Project of Youth from Teesdale. So let's go check that out now. Youth around here face a lot of stigma, and with these murals, we wanted them to focus on positive messages that they can set any goals for themselves and strive to achieve them. This is never a cliche for me, especially for young people deemed to be at risk in marginalized neighborhoods where their potentialities are often at odds with lowered expectations and lack of resources. I'm illegally parked right now, so let's get back to the car. Okay, on to the next site. Now for this next location, it's still under the graffiti transformation project and working with those youth, but it's at a different site, and it's here by the Birchmount Community Center. Oh, whoops. But don't worry, through the magic of editing and voiceovers, I was supposed to be saying that the murals are actually by the Birchmount Stadium and not the community center. Now, I was hoping that the gates would be open, but unsurprisingly enough, they were locked and we can't go close to the pieces. Luckily, I've taken photos of them in the past, and here they are. So here we are at Scarborough Bluffs, at the site of one of the first murals that we did under the graffiti transformation program. It's pretty fun working here because during our lunch breaks we would go to the beach and sometimes have a barbecue, and so that was quite memorable. And I was working with the youth under the Youth Justice Services to create these murals, and they weren't like artists or anything like that, but look what they were able to achieve. And this was a pretty challenging site because you can see of the sheer height of it, the physicality of it. So that was quite a bit of a challenge. This one's been tagged quite badly, and you can see where they tried to clean it off. Basically, there are two pieces, one behind me and one right there to my right. And they show the bluffs during the night and the day. Okay, bluffs, it's been real. On to the next site. I've just arrived at the next location here at downtown Toronto, and I don't know if you're able to see, but the whole entire place is under construction right now. But maybe I can do a quick run and just show you guys what's going on. And right now, the condo building where the mural is at Jarvis on Dundas, along Jarvis. I forget now what number it is for the address, but it's right at the very corner. You can't miss it. It's a gigantic building. Now, the piece is called The Original Family, and it's essentially the native story of creation. And it was designed by two native artists, Philip Cote III and Nelly who got in touch with William Lazos, who is the main artist that that leads my my crew. So I'm gonna quickly run across the street and check out the site, and I'm gonna do as best as I can, show you the entire piece, but like I said before, that parking lot is under construction at the moment. So let's go. Thank you.
are right now currently at Fraser Avenue in Liberty Village here in downtown Toronto. So that building that I just passed by, which is currently behind me, is the DCM Toronto building, which is the Abnormal Beauty Company. And inside, they've got this beautiful, massive office that we were given the opportunity to paint a mural for, about a couple of years ago. And again, it's closed off because of the pandemic, and I can't go in there to show you, but here's a quick snap of those murals that we've done for them. And right beside the DCM building is another huge, gigantic building of studios. Now there are different like firms and art studios in here. And the owner of the place got our crew to paint for them an illusionistic and realistic painting around there at the parking lot. So let's get to that now and I can show you around, and hopefully it's not closed off. Okay, it's closed off to cars, but we can certainly walk in. Just across from us is the Gardiner Expressway there, and just beyond that is the Canadian National Exhibition Place. Now, you see this beautifully painted silo? We didn't paint that. Now, as you can see, this back parking lot area is badly tagged, and by that, I mean in bad taste and in bad form. And here is our piece. It was tagged while we were painting it, but thankfully, it hasn't been tagged since. Part of the idea in painting the mural here is, of course, to beautify the place and deter further vandalism, but one can never really tell with taggers just out to vandalize without any real sense or respect for the craft. Okay, so for this next site, it was for a private home, and I'm not gonna disclose the address. I'm not too entirely sure, the legalities of that, or just for safety reasons. But just to be safe, I will say that it's close to O'Hara Drive and Queen Street, at a back alleyway running parallel to O'Hara Drive. Okay, just arrived here at Spadina and Dupont area by the Spadina station, and it's getting pretty dark now, but I think we'll be able to get through all of my locations that I planned for today before it gets dark. Now, this next piece is again a design of the indigenous artist Philip Cote. The piece is titled History of the Land, and it depicts the journey of the ice runners of the Anishinaabe peoples. They are believed to have crossed the Glacier ice plains about 100,000 years before the current indigenous populations here. And the mural is a representation of the hunting grounds that the Anishinaabe ice runners roamed during this journey. There are quite a few of us that worked on this mural, and I'm going to link the handles of the rest of the artists that worked on this mural with me.
By the way, just two blocks north of this mural is Casa Loma. Welcome to Toronto's Little Manila. There are more than a quarter of a million of Filipinos in Toronto, and Bathurst and Wilson is home to tens of thousands of Filipino families, making it one of the largest concentrations of Filipinos in the city. So it's no surprise that our next location is attended by mostly Filipino students.
So I finally reached the final site for today, and it was just enough light. It's getting kind of dark now, but I think we're still okay. And it's windy, and hopefully this mic isn't going too crazy.
In 2016 to 2017, St. Margaret Catholic School was in the thick of a dispute that involved hundreds of Filipino students and their families, their educators, the Toronto Catholic District School Board, and the Ontario Ministry of Education. For more than a decade, St. Margaret has been facing space issues and lack of resources, and since 2015 has had over 600 students, 90% of whom are Filipino, crammed in a building designed with a capacity for 300. Concerned parents from the Parent Engagement and Community Empowerment Council, or PEACE for short, and along with community members and organizations, brought forward issues of overcrowding, delayed school repairs, overworked teachers, and falling education standards to various media outlets, to the attention of the school board and Ministry of Education, and highlighted larger issues of systemic racism and marginalization at play within the education system. To help boost morale, a friend and a member of the Peace Council put me in touch with St. Margaret's principal to create murals with some of the students. Sadly, much of these issues persist as the school board and trustees continue to delay the building of a new school or address the needs of the students with utmost priority. This brings our mural tour to a close, but there are a few missed pieces that I wish we could have visited. Nonetheless, here's a snapshot of Father Sarah Elementary School's library, which is way off the grid and is closed anyways. The other two were in restaurants downtown, both of which are now permanently closed. One due to a fire, and the other was turned over to new owners. But man, I'm beat, so I'm going home. And I'm home. Oh man, that was a lot of work, but I had a lot of fun, and I hope that you also enjoyed that. Ooh. So there goes the first time for me vlogging outside this room, and it really certainly helped that I had this camera along with me to be able to film myself and have that autofocus. And you know what, honestly, it was harder than I thought, and just kind of remembering what to say and how to say it is an acquired skill. And you know what, I felt so funny just talking to the camera, especially when somebody would walk by and they would stare at you and look at you, and that would just make me feel all sorts of funny. Like even just remembering to look at the lens instead of the screen while I speak. So there's definitely a lot of room for me to improve on, but I can't wait to do it again. And also just planning this video in general took a lot more work than I expected. And you know what, kudos to vloggers that do this on a regular basis, because man, I don't know how you guys, some of you guys upload like every day. I don't even know how that happens. But it was a lot of fun for me just having to go around and look at my past murals, just a chance to get out of the house, obey safely and responsibly given everything that's going on right now. But yeah, thanks for tagging along and thanks for watching until the end. And if you like this content and hope to see more, please click like, sub share, and don't forget to hit that notification bell for future uploads. Stay safe and healthy, everyone. Eye-catching out, and I'll see you next time.
That's not just a camera, Harry. That's the cannon M50.